West edition of The Property Show. It's Diwali week, the most auspicious time in the calendar to purchase a home, and there is no better time than now to get a good deal on your property purchase. So today, as you call in, we'll help you shortlist best developing projects, we'll help you identify locations which offer you the kind of lifestyle you want for your family. Coming up on the West edition. For investors and home seekers, top of the chart projects within 1 to 1.5 crores in Mumbai. Is the upcoming international airport in Navi Mumbai still driving real estate in Panvel? Also, a look at the top residential deals in Panvel. From budget homes in Badlapur to mid-income flats in Thane's Shilpata. Also from Pune, affordable 1 BHK options in Talegaon and Hinjewadi to best price 3 BHKs on Sous Road. Real estate veteran PNC Menon of Sobha Developers forecasts a turnaround for the sector by the end of 2016. We get you an exclusive chat with one of the most respected voices in the business. And transgenders in Mumbai get forced to vacate their flats, face discrimination from housing societies. On Citizens Voice, we ask, what are the housing rights of the LGBT community in India? All right, let's take up your questions for Andheri, Ghatkopar, Panvel and Thane. First caller on the show with us, Swapnil Bhargav. Hi Swapnil, how can we help you?
Good evening, wishes for the festivity.
Thank you so much, happy Diwali to you.
So, I am looking for investment in a project by the name of The Rising City. It is on Ghatkopar Mankhurd Link Road. My horizon of investment is 5 to 6 years, and my budget is close to 1.5 crore.
Okay.
So, I just thought of taking your view. Would it be wise to invest in this project as it has been stalled for some time? But I am more interested in this project from investment perspective from the from the view that it is strategically located near to BKC, near to airport, near to Eastern Express Highway.
Okay, all right. So, Rising City on the Ghatkopar Mankhurd Link Road. Swapnil is very excited about the location of this project. Sameer, from an investment standpoint, in the coming years, where do you see this property going?
Well, we definitely think it's a good project. The weighted average price of the market is much higher than the price of this project as well. So from a price point, it's okay. Location connectivity is fantastic. It's 3.5 kilometers from the Ghatkopar metro station and about 3.6 kilometers from the Chembur monorail station. And connectivity is the most important factor literally in the Mumbai region. And properties with great connectivity tend to appreciate faster. This project is a JV between Hubtown, Rajesh Lifestyle and Marathon Group, and this project is a large one spread across 128 acres with all modern amenities to be developed in three phases. The project is trading at 12,991 rupees a square foot, and if you were to look at some of the key data points of Ghatkopar East with respect to the mid segment, 23 months of inventory overhang, 13,700 being the weighted average price of the market. And price appreciation has also been fairly reasonable, about 12% on an annualized basis. The two other projects are Gandhiraj by Mishal Construction at 14,000 rupees a square foot. This is a redevelopment project, standalone tower with S plus 15 stories. Developer has delivered quite a few projects here. Location at plot number 25 near Acharya Atre ground. Then we have Solstice by Neelam Realtors at 14 to 15,000 rupees a square foot. This is a redevelopment project with two towers. Construction has already started in the 8th slab. Work is going on. Amenities include a banquet hall and a clubhouse. And developer also has delivered quite a few projects here.
All right. So Swapnil, that's a definite yes for Rising City by Rare Township in Ghatkopar East. Location is indeed very good, close to the Ghatkopar metro station, the monorail station, and also you have connectivity through the Eastern Expressway. Also going ahead, there is a proposed metro phase 3 from Ghatkopar to Thane, which is in the pipeline. So from this market, Swapnil, we have three more options for you. Look at Ganadhiraj by Mishal Constructions and Solstice by Neelam Realtors. Okay, now with us on the line, Anurag Srivastava. Anurag, hi, how can we help you?
Hi, I'm looking out for 2 BHK with amenities like health clubs, swimming pool, community center. It should be ready to move in flat and preferably in Andheri area only. and my budget is maximum 1.2 crores. Please suggest good options. Thank you so much.
Okay, so in Andheri, within 1 to 1.3 crores, Anurag is looking for a project that will give him the complete package of all amenities, sports facilities. Sameer, what are his options?
You'll have to up your budget a little bit to about 1.3 odd crores to be able to get the right accommodation with respect to your requirement. Andheri is now priced at a weighted average price scale of about 15,000 rupees a square foot. Inventory overhang is a cause of concern here because of slow sales, 36 months, and the price appreciation has been reasonably decent at about 10% on an annualized basis. Montego by Gundecha Builders is one project that you could consider. Project is ready in final stages, finishing work is going on. It's still available with the developer, trading on a carpet price of 16,500 rupees a square foot. Besides, located only 1 kilometer from the metro station, it is only 4 kilometers from the domestic terminal as well. Basic amenities are only being offered in this project. Then you have DSK Madhukosh by DS Kulkarni Developers at 12,500. This project consists of 3 towers. Project is located 3.5 kilometers from the international airport. Amenities like swimming pool, clubhouse, fitness center are a part of this complex, and it's also located near the Safid Pool, Andheri Kulla Road. Lastly, we have Crescent Residency in Andheri East at 13,750 rupees a square foot. This is a redevelopment project spread across 39,000 square feet. Building plans of this are in place. Developers delivered Crescent Hillview and Crescent Plaza in Mumbai. It's a standalone building with 2 wings of G plus 11 stories.
All right. Sameer, 3,000 units still available in the Andheri East market. Would it be possible to estimate if there is enough ready stock here? Is this a market with a lot of ready stock for buyers in this budget?
Well, you can safely say that not lots of ready stock would be there, but ample enough for a person who is looking to make a choice on a ready project to be able to get his requirement. So if you were to look at the total number of projects, apartments say about 3,000. So you could safely say about 700 odd apartments may be ready.
Okay, that's still quite a significant number. Okay, so Anurag in Andheri East, properties average at about 50,000 rupees per square foot. And the projects we're giving you are getting delivered this year or by end of 2016. You could look at Montego by Gundecha Builders, DSK Madhukosh by DS Kulkarni Developers, and Crescent Residency by Crescent Constructions. An email comes in from Ashish Rajput. He writes, I want to purchase a flat in Panvel for investment purpose as the new international airport is proposed there. Looking for a 2 BHK with a budget of 60 to 70 lakhs from a good developer in a township with all modern amenities. I heard about Arihant Akanksha project of Arihant Superstructures in Panvel. I expect possession by 2018-19. Okay, so Panvel, this market, everybody is always excited about because of the international airport. Sameer, what is your feedback on Arihant Akanksha?
Yeah, from our point of view, the project gets a go-ahead. This project is spread on 24 acres of land, offering a lot of amenities. If you were to look at the type of amenities, swimming pool, jacuzzi, business lounge, jogging track, basketball court, skating rink, indoor games room. So all the facilities that you can think of are being provided over here. Developers also got a good track record of delivering quite a few projects in Navi Mumbai. And the project has about 8 odd towers of 35 stories. And this project is located in the Palaspe Fata near the Marathon Nextone project. Looking at the key data points of this micro market, inventory overhang is at 30 months, clearly investor-driven market, with sales now slowly picking up because of the international airport announcement. 5,300 being the weighted average price of the mid-segment, and 8.8% is the analyzed appreciation of this market. India Bulls Green Phase 2 by India Bulls is the other option that you can consider, spread across 80 acres of land to be delivered in phases. India Bulls has quite a few amenities, including malls and international schools, hospitals, besides clubhouse of 7 acres in the complex, in this whole project itself. And the project's building plan is approved. And lastly, you have Marathon Nextone Atria by Marathon Group at 5,851 rupees a square foot. This project has also got great amenities, including 2 swimming pools, a tennis and a squash court, jogging tracks, recreation ground for events as well. And this project is located on JNPT Road and is 4.3 kilometers from the Panvel station and 1.4 kilometers from the ONGC hospital. So connectivity and social infrastructure quite well nearby.
Okay. Sameer, for Panvel, for festive home seekers, is Panvel the node of Navi Mumbai that they should be watching out for? A lot of supply still there in the market?
Well, in my view, if you're a really long-term investor, Panvel could be a good micro market to consider. But if you're a short-term investor, then Khargar seems to be a better bet. So
better
if it's
fit?
A 3 to 4 year horizon, Khargar. If it's a 4 to 8 year horizon, then I would recommend Panvel.
Okay, so probably for end users, for home seekers, Khargar is a better bet compared to Panvel, which will take longer to come up. Of course, proximity to the international airport has drawn bulk of the investments here. Recently, the Maharashtra CM stated that they're opening financial bids for the Navi Mumbai International Airport. So work on that is progressing. Many hotel majors have also announced their hotel projects for Navi Mumbai. Also going ahead, a 48 kilometer long high-speed rail link is proposed between Panvel and CST Mumbai. This will cut down traveling time between the twin cities. So Ashish, we have two options for you from Panvel. You could look at India Bulls Greens Phase 2 by India Bulls Real Estate. There's also Marathon Next Zone by Atria Marathon Group. Okay, Rajesh Shah now with us. Hi Rajesh, what's your question?
Madam, I want to buy a property between Badnapur to Karjat. Which is the base property? I am having a budget of 22 lakhs and want to buy a 2 BHK flat.
Okay, quite a tight budget there, 22 lakhs, looking for a 2 BHK from Ambernath to Karjat.
Well, keeping your requirement in mind, from Ambernath to Karjat, we would recommend Badlapur to you. It's an affordable destination. Connectivity is also reasonable through the Badlapur railway station. Several developers are coming up with large size residential developments over here. Good developers trying to build projects. Looking at the key data points also, pretty sound data points, so 18 months of inventory overhang, which is very positive. For 10,000 units, only 390 available. The weighted average price of the market stands at a very affordable price point of 3,300 rupees for the mid segment, and price appreciation is about 7.5% on an annualized basis. The projects that you can consider, and these are very attractive price points, considering the projects are all ready as well. Tulsi Sandhya by Tulsi Estate project is ready, spread across 1 acre, so small project. Developers delivered 6 projects in MMR. In this small project also, they're offering you a clubhouse, open amphitheater, indoor games as well. The project is only 500 meters from the Guardian Dental College and 250 meters from the SICES College. Then you have Motiram Lakeview by Motiram Dalal Group. This project consists of 4 buildings. Project is 3 kilometers from the Bardapur railway station. Developers delivered about 2 projects already, and amenities here also include a clubhouse and indoor games. And lastly, we have Jewel Arista Phase 1 by Jewel Builders at 3,000 rupees a square foot, spread across 3.5 acres with 14 towers. Phase 1 is open with 9 towers, and developers delivered about 3 projects in the MMR region.
Okay, so 3 affordable options for you in Badlapur. Average prices here at around 3,300 rupees per square foot. You could look at, let's recap those options that Sameer just spoke about. There is Tulsi Sanidhya by Tulsi Estate. This project is ready for possession but awaiting an occupation certificate. You could look at Motiram Lakeview by Motiram Dalal Group. Just received an OC giving handover. There's also Jewel Arista Phase 1 by Jewel Builders. This one is in advanced stages of getting completed. Next question, Sanjeet Pathak with us. He writes us an email saying, I have a budget of 60 lakhs. My location preferences are Shilfata in Thane. And I want to know the future prospects of Eco Vista by Bharat Developers. My budget is 60 lakhs, looking for a 2 BHK.
Well, Sanjeet, Shilfata is a reasonably good destination at this point, with an inventory overhang standing at 22 months, so it's much below the danger zone. Prices have gone up to about 5,050 rupees a square foot on the weighted average price scale for all segments, and price appreciation has been in line with the market, roughly around 10% on an annualized basis. The project that you've shortlisted, Eco Vistas Phase 2, is at 5,200 rupees a square foot, so in line with the weighted average price of the market. Maybe slightly more expensive. It's spread across 8 acres. This project amenities are reasonably good, which include a swimming pool, clubhouse, a tranquility pavilion hall, meditation hall, and two more projects that you can consider in the Shilpata region are Arihant Arohi. This project is cheaper, 4950 is an offer price that is being offered right now compared to an actual price of 5100 rupees. You can further negotiate a little bit because of Diwali period, and developers are more than happy to negotiate if you are willing to close a deal. Lodha School is about 2.9 kilometers away only, and project is spread across 2.5 acres offering you amenities which include a swimming pool and a clubhouse, library and a gym. And lastly, we have Planet North at 6460 rupees a square foot, but this is an all-inclusive price which also includes a fully furnished option with 25 branded goods and or a free car option. They're offering you a car if you buy this project. The project is offering you clubhouse, health club, restaurant, swimming pool, tennis court amongst the amenities, and the project will be ready by December 2016, and it's 1.7 kilometers from the Shilpata Junction.
Okay, so a couple of government initiatives are going to benefit the urban landscape of Shilpata. There is a Mahape Shilpata flyover which is close to completion. This is going to ease the traffic rush in this area during peak hours. Also, a blueprint is ready for developing a business hub in Kalyan to boost the employment opportunities in the adjoining areas. Also, MMRDA has accepted this plan for a growth centre which will come up on about 5,500 hectares of land between Nilaje and Kalyan city. Sanjeet, for you, the options, let's recap them. Arihant Arohi by Arihant Superstructures and Planet North by Dosti Realty. We now have an exclusive conversation with a man who built a real estate empire in India from absolutely nothing. When the industry was still building the old traditional way, he was racing ahead with modern construction practices. And even in today's market, his company, Sobha Group, continues to deliver quality projects on time and at best prices. We are talking about Sobha Group's chairman and founder, PNC Menon, who spoke exclusively to NDTV's Nikhil Narayan Shividas on his outlook for the real estate markets.
Real estate business is a very cyclical business. There are ups and downs. Geography to geography, the cycle of that up and down together is different. Whatever little I have started mapping how exactly the cycle is. According to me, the Indian cycle is about 5 years, 3 years positive and 2 years negative. Okay. The negative cycle of India, the last negative cycle of India started in the second half 14 and will continue in 15. According to me, the first half of 16 also could be negative. And we'll again get into positive cycle of 3 years from the second half of 16.
Market over here is going through a slump right now. Prices are too high, people are not buying. And you yourself have stated many times in the past that Mumbai, the prices are just inordinately high. So do you feel that developers should cut prices to spur growth? Is there room for them to cut prices?
See, what I've seen is there are two issues. One is the sentiment of the market. When you go through negative cycle, it's not that people don't want to buy. They will not buy during the negative sentiment because their expectation is that the price will come down. They don't want to cut a check at that point of. Not that we do not have a requirement, but what happens with builder? They go through, unless the financial engineering is done properly, they go through a real bad period in terms of their finances. So I will say that, you know, according to me, price reduction is not a solution to it. But if you have taken a price to a level which is not right, definitely this gives an opportunity to correct and stay at the right current price.
So if you look at the Bombay market, do you feel prices have reached a level where they can bring it back down a bit?
I have a feeling yes, they can bring it back. And the prices in Mumbai has become highly unreasonable. This is a fact.
Okay, that's PNC Menon calling a spade a spade. It's time to bring prices down in the Mumbai property market, he says. The West edition of the Property Show continues after this quick commercial break. Up ahead, we will focus on affordable residential locations of Pune. And we continue to track latest projects in the market and on our scanner today, Vadha Courtyard in Thane West.